Hi, I'm Tim. Welcome to Watchbox, and thanks for logging on. If you love this watch, please email me, teammosso@thewatchbox.com. It's in the description below. It is your purchase and pricing email question line for buying this or any watch you see on any Watchbox platform. Please reach out to me directly, email teammosso@thewatchbox.com for pricing details. Today, we're discussing a watch that was launched in 2013 and discontinued in 2021. Built in no more than a few dozen examples per year, it was throughout this period the flagship of the manufacturer Romain Gauthier out of the Vallée du Jeu. This is, in many ways, the watch that put the brand on the market and its icon to date. So, the Logical One from the Heritage Collection. You can see this example in white gold, 43 millimeters in diameter, 14.2 millimeters thick, 52.7 millimeters from lug to lug, with a 22 millimeter spacing between the lugs. It's a large watch, being almost 53 millimeters from lug to lug. It's got a hell of a wingspan. Now, there is some curvature to the lug, so maybe it's not as bad as you might think ergonomically. I could wear it on my wrist of 16 centimeters circumference, but I do think this is the minimum. Any smaller and the lugs would be over the edge of my wrist, and that's the no-go for me. You can see down the barrel, it does wear well. It's not a thin watch, although the sloped case flank will help a jacket sleeve to ramp up over the side. It is hefty. You can really feel where the money went. If you're of the persuasion that a luxury watch shouldn't feel toy-like the way ceramic and titanium do, this is your watch. All in gray gold, too. Gray gold, by the way, is white gold that never has to be plated. It's white all the way through, 18 karat, homogeneous, never needs to be plated, and if it does get scratched, it's the same color underneath. It's the good stuff. It's what JLC, Rolex, Patek, Grubel all use. Now, the strap, as you can see, is a Romain Gauthier factory strap, and calfskin on the bottom, brand new, no crimping or gouging. Large symmetrical scale alligator leather. This is a very expensive cut. The best kind is large symmetrical scale. Matte finish, medium brown. It's got a folded edge. It's got a monotone stitch. And it's connected to a pin buckle that is actually a little bit of an inside joke. As you can see, the bevels inside meet in sharp interior angles. And the watch really trades on its abundance of these junctions, and nowhere is that more evident than on the reverse side of the case. But first, let's talk about the case. Forgive my fingerprints. This case is in outstanding condition, but I don't wear gloves because I don't want to risk dropping a watch, and that is what happens when you wear gloves. So you can see the watch features a combination of recesses within the lugs that are media blast, and then the remainder is in high polish. You can also see how the lugs are crafted with long arcing sculptural forms and then welded to the case with evidence of the weld removed to create these sharp break lines between lugs and case. This is very slow-going, labor-intensive, artisanal case manufacture. And you can see how complex the case shape is, as it goes from pretty much convex all the way to concave at its bottom. There is a concave bezel profile. Everything's polished. We have a Romain Gauthier crown that's polished and media blasted. This is the crown that you use for setting the watch, just like this. And then this is the trigger that you use for winding the watch, just like this. The dial, such as it is, two-piece, both grand faux enamel, fired in a kiln on solid gold dial basis, glass-based paint that's been cooked up to 20 times at 800 degrees Celsius to create a lush, lovely, lasting beauty. That's the advantage of enamel. You could see blue on white printing, and then there are these signature screws used all over the watch, including on external assembly. And these are proprietary screws by Gauthier. They allow the watchmaker to apply more torque without the risk of stripping out the head of the screw as you might with a flathead, so you can apply more torque for better security. Now, the finishing is just blinding. Look at the solarization on the balance cock. Look at how the bevels come to a sharp point. Outer points where two bevels meet are as impressive as inner points where two bevels create a crease. Yet we have tons of those as well. Outer point adjacent to inner point. Look at them right next to each other there. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 sharp interior angles just on the balance cock. Many, many more on the steel bridge for the fusée and chain. Look at that. Look how sharp those angles are, and they're all internal. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. That's just one component made of steel. You could see that the bridge has been continuously rounded across its top and mirror polished, and we have enormous partridge eye style beveling in all of the sinks for the jewels. The base plate has been gilded and media blasted. You can also see solarization on the single-sided cock for the escape wheel, as well as adjacent to that, actual media blasting on its top. Note the combination of solarization, polish, satination, and media blasting, all in close proximity on this one component. And then also take note that all the screw heads have been black polished. The wheel within a wheel motif that is a signature of Romain Gauthier is present underneath the dial. You can just barely see it in the escape wheel and then the train wheels. And of course, Romain Gauthier, not a watchmaker, he draws on his friends from his native Vallée du Jeu to inspire the finishing style of his watches, particularly Philippe Dufour, with whom he has a good long-term friendship. So while this watch is definitely not in the style of Dufour, the finishing is very much to his standard. Now, Gauthier is an MBA, he's a businessman, and he's an engineer with a specialization in precision machining. That's one of the reasons he makes so many of these parts himself. The wheels, the balance, which is free sprung and beats away at 4 hertz. He even makes a lot of the components for Chanel watches, since Chanel is a stakeholder in Romain Gauthier. And while Chanel will admit that Gauthier makes the wheels for Chanel high horology watches, privately, folks from Romain Gauthier insist that it's a lot more than that, up to and including engineering and watchmaking. So Gauthier has a very signature style, and he thinks differently about things because he's steeped in engineering, not watchmaking tradition. And that's where we get this unique snail cam fusée. So the way this works is the chain is fully black polished. I'll show you the inside of the chain. Look carefully, and you could see that there are 26 pivot jewels acting as roller bearings inside of the chain. And the chain engages a snail cam, and the snail cam changes the effective ratio with which the gear ratio with which the barrel pulls on the train that activates the escapement. So as the barrel loses torque, the ratio itself changes, and the snail cam presents its largest outer diameter to the chain. So because the diameter being pulled by the barrel gets larger and larger, the amount of torque necessary to apply the same amount of force to the escapement, the amount of torque in the barrel necessary becomes less and less. So the mechanical advantage increases as the barrel loses its force. Now, traditionally, this would be done with a barrel, a really long chain, and some sort of hyperboloid-shaped fusée. But here it's achieved with a snail cam, a totally different conception of the fusée that takes up less space. And critically, it keeps the drawing wheel driven by the barrel and the cam in the same plane. So there's no cross-chaining going on, which can create problems with efficiency. So this gives you constant force to the escapement like a fusée, but it's an unprecedented way of building a fusée and chain. And you can see all the parts right down to the wheels and the underlying winding mechanism individually finished to an extraordinary standard. We also have satination and solarization on the base plate. You can see that well. So we have media blast, polish and beveling, and then satination on the base plate. All the parts that are silver are made of steel. They're satinated, media blasted, and black polished in turn. Turn it all over, you can see more of those interior angles where bevels meet in sharp inward creases. Too many of them to count. And taking after Philippe Dufour, drawing the bevels out incredibly broad across the surfaces at the edge of the bridges. In fact, making the bridges thicker so that the bevels can be drawn broader and further across the top. You can also see that we have more of those sharp exterior points, interior angles, a mile long. We have a power reserve indicator on the reverse side. The manual wind power reserve is 46 hours. 37 jewels represents the jewels that are in the train and the winding system and the fusée, but there are 26 additional jewels inside the chain. As you could see, those wheel within a wheel recursive designs on the backside, and more finishing of the bridges and the steel in comparable levels of artistry. Now you can see the barrel, which looks like it might be an open barrel at first glance, but it's never a good thing to have an open barrel because debris and dirt from the barrel can contaminate the rest of the movement. So Romain Gauthier killed two birds with one stone here. By creating a barrel that is lined with sapphire, you have what looks like an open barrel, so you can see the coiling of the mainspring, but across its top and around its interior circumference, it's all lined with sapphire to contain any debris that might work its way free, but also to permit a much lower coefficient of friction than if the spring were in contact with the metallic wall of the barrel. So a lot of incredible original thinking and watchmaking going on here. And then all this water resistant to a dress watch standard 30 meters. A very, very special watch, discontinued, and no one version of this watch made an even more than a few dozen copies. The best finishing you can buy, others are co-equal, but I can't honestly say that anyone's clearly better. Reach out to Team Mosso at thewatchbox.com for purchase and pricing details.